Hey mom, I know you're my number one fan and that you watch all my videos, but you might want to sit this one out. What's up guys, it's your favorite capitalist scum and this week we have some really interesting news. First off, the latest controversy with YouTube. Attention has been brought to a genre of video that's been popping up involving the torture of animals on YouTube. Now apparently this all started from a Spanish channel that was getting away with doing it back in the day, and according to Moist Critical, there are copycat channels inspired by him doing the same exact thing. Now YouTube has recently banned the account of Leafy Is Here, a channel with 4 million subs with 3 strikes all at once. Meanwhile, this channel known as Pollution Entertainment is currently still up. The videos have been privated or removed, but there is clear evidence of that from the channel's social blade statistics. The channel lost millions of views instantly, which means that many videos were privated or removed all at the same time. And now the other problem are these fake animal rescue channels, where people are pretending to rescue animals that they themselves have either harmed or put in harm's way. Channels that put puppies and kittens into terrible situations and pretend that they're helping them. There's a video on a channel where they claim that they saved a puppy from another dog that bit it. And if you watch the video, it's quite obvious a freaking stab wound. These people stabbed a puppy in the chest just to clean it up and act like they're helping it. Or another video where it looks like they stuck a puppy between some truck tires and backed over it enough so that it was stuck and screaming. Why does it look like that's the case? Because this guy spent 2 minutes in the same lot with all these trucks saying, "Hey guys, today we're gonna save a puppy from under a truck. And as you can see, there are a lot of trucks here, but where's the dog? I don't know." And then it immediately cuts and you're able to hear a screaming puppy as this man turns his head and is like, "Oh my gosh, I hear it, guys. There it is." A truck that was literally visible to him and right out of frame to us, the viewer, while he was looking around. He's literally standing next to it. "Oh my gosh, where could this puppy be?" And then bam, screaming puppy magically appears. How this kind of stuff is allowed on YouTube is a mystery, but it's even more apparent because of our next story. Now we have a quickly developing arc in the YouTube anime, and that is the guideline strikes on Moist Critical's channel. The strikes are on a video that he put out a couple days ago of a very old clip of an obviously fake video of a road rage incident gone hilarious. Critical got a strike on his channel and the video removed, and after climbing the ladder all the way through YouTube, the decision was declared final. Now after he went to Twitter about it, he pointed out that Markiplier, known as one of the most wholesome channels on YouTube with 27 million subs, has the same exact clip in one of his "You Laugh, You Lose" videos. So he tweets this out like, "Hey, he has the same exact clip in his video. Why doesn't he have a strike, huh?" And Markiplier then retweets it and is like, "Yeah, that's fair. Where's my strike? I have the same exact, you know, clip in my video." And what does YouTube do, fellas? They double down on it. They literally double down on it. They then proceed to give Markiplier a strike on his channel. Now at this point, everyone's freaking lost it. It's complete chaos. They've had enough, boys. There's riots in the street. Wait, that's actually happening. You get the point. YouTube almost immediately caved after that. They released a tweet literally saying, "We don't want to die on this hill." Completely revert the action. Critical and Markiplier both had their strikes removed and their videos reinstated, setting a crazy precedent for the future. The decision to strike the videos was manual, which means someone at YouTube marked it as against their guidelines and removed the video. A once permanent strike has now just been removed, which changes the game completely. Nothing is final anymore, boys. Who knows, maybe Leafy will find his way back. It's also brought a lot of attention to the fact that the different departments on YouTube have like no contact with each other. They don't know how to communicate. They can't ever figure anything out. But yeah, that's that story. That developed super quickly in like the course of 24 hours almost. Now the next story is about MrBeast being canceled. Now, cancel culture is freaking stupid, mainly because cancel culture usually comes from outdated information, like this MrBeast situation. If you don't know who MrBeast is, he's that guy that has the unlimited money cheat in real life, giving away cars, houses, money, literally everything. It's like that one meme with Oprah. He's also the Team Trees guy, the, you know, planting all the trees and stuff. What'd he get canceled for? For making fun of the 53 genders there are to choose from on Facebook, and that he identifies as an attack helicopter. Now this is apparently a no-no nowadays, where you can't make this sort of joke because they're offensive and outdated. Why in today's landscape he would make that joke, I have no idea. Oh wait, he didn't make it in this landscape. He made it back in 2016 when everyone was making that joke because it was hilarious. I bet there's not a one of you that hasn't heard the I identify as an attack helicopter. Now, this is all stupid. He's not getting canceled. It's not gonna work. It's not gonna happen. He's done too much. He's done a lot of freaking stuff. I immediately knew that it was old news because of the fact that there are 53 genders. That's not a thing, all right? If you're a big brain like me and did any research at all, you'd know that there are, in fact, 58 genders. So do some research, boys. You know, now that I look at it, like 80% of these are literally the same exact thing. I don't understand it. Anywho, the point is, it's stupid. It's not gonna work. MrBeast literally gives more money to charity than anyone who is upset about this will ever see in their life. So it was a good try, and I await their next victim of cancel culture so I can report on it. All right, I think that's all we're gonna have for today, boys. Leave a like, comment. Comments are fun. I like reading the comments. Those always turn out great. I don't know if y'all noticed, but there's like one guy in the comments who he literally just keeps posting like different song lyrics every single video. Just a different one every single time. Good meme. All right, everyone, have a good one.